What's going on, everybody? Thanks for tuning in. I'm Huff, and I'm here representing Natives, and we are here at the showcase, the Native Showcase, and I'm here with the beautiful, lovely Miss Briella, who will be performing today.
Hey.
You know, singer, songwriter, poet, triple threat, whatever you want to call it, and you know, we're just gonna talk a little bit and let you guys get an inside look at what we're doing here, and you know, and what's going on. So, thanks for tuning in. By the way, so Briella, you know, it's funny because I feel like usually when you're watching an artist, you don't get to see like how much of them as a person, because you're just watching them, you know, perform, and they don't really get to know you. So we like, where I come from, we like icebreakers,
okay.
Right? So you know, so one of my favorite things to ask people is like, if you wanted somebody to get a better idea of you and who you are as a person and some of your interests, what movie would you tell them to watch? Any movie. And if you can't think of a movie, a show. Netflix series, like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, I think a show that they could watch would be New Girl.
Alright, why New Girl?
New Girl because I feel like her personality is as weird as mine.
Okay.
She's very, like, she wants to help people with everything in her being, you know, all the time. And it's to a point where she kind of, like, messes up things, but I relate to that. And then she lives with four men. For like her brothers basically, and I have that kind of like lifestyle where all of my neighbors were brother boys and those were my brothers and I grew up around guys, and she's really creative, she'll like knit things out of nothing and I like using my hands, and she's a teacher, she likes, you know, helping young people and everything like that, so there's a lot of relatability.
Wow, I feel like I'm sleeping on New Girl.
No, yeah, it's so funny, it's this weird comedic humor, like my boyfriend doesn't get it, but it's
as long as you appreciate it, right?
Oh, yeah.
He kind of has to, you know what I'm saying? Happy girlfriend, happy life, something
happy,
like that.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Something like that. But anyways, so you've been doing music for how long now?
I started writing as a kid. So I was like in elementary school, I started writing poetry, and I've been actually performing music starting in high school.
Okay.
Yeah.
Wow, so you're not new to this.
No.
You're true to this. That's what's up.
Thank
that's
God.
What's up.
Shout out Mr. Eves, my guitar teacher in high school.
Hey.
Thank you.
The foundation.
Yeah.
That's what my grandma used to always say. It's wild. That's funny. So yeah, you've been doing music for a while now. You know, Miss V's put you onto the guitar. Praise God for those mentors that come into our lives, right? You know, it's funny because I mean, from the artists that I've gotten to know on a personal level, they always had like a moment in which like they realized that they wanted to do music, or somebody who introduced them to music. Like, was there an artist or a person who introduced you to an artist that, you know, kind of like put you on, you know, to this genre or this form of art that kind of made you realize that this is what you wanted to do?
It's, I don't know if there was something or somebody specifically that put that in there.
Okay.
I think it was kind of more genetic. My mom has some, like, artistic talent, and she never lived them out. So I realized really young that I could sing and I like poetry, and then it was just a matter of putting me on a stage. And then I started realizing, like, hey, I can do this, I like this, I have a gift for it. And there are people, I'm trying to think, like, I know I've watched a couple performances and I was looking at the people and I'm like, I could do that.
Yeah.
That's me, like, on that stage. It's just like, give me some time, I could be that person. But it was really just a matter of exposure and finally getting, I was really shy as a kid. So getting me on a stage and giving me that time to shine really just gave me the opportunity to see, like, hey, I can do this.
Right, you're conquering that fear.
Right, exactly. And it was kind of my grade. It was with Mr. Eves, it was mandatory to get on stage and play. So I was like, all right.
Got to.
Yeah, it's about that time.
True.
Yeah, so it was just a matter of time.
Wow, that's cool. Okay, so who would you consider some of your, like, you know, idols or people you look up to in the industry? Or, like, you know, whether present, past, you know?
Yeah, as far as, like, inspirations, I really enjoy Erica Badu,
Legend,
of course, India Arvi, Lauryn Hill. Lauryn Hill specifically because she has this ability to mix in her poetry. She has a deep message and she mixes in her music. And I have a lot of that. And I did a merge them together and studying and looking into Lauryn Hill's music. Like, it gave me hope. Like, I can do this. I can make this an art form and continue that kind of legacy that she started. And Sharon, another music guitarist. And,
he's an artist,
yeah. He's an amazing lyricist. Like, I have to take for work. My mom had a really, like, rough time in the street when I was younger.
Yeah.
So we used to go to a hospital when I was bring my dictionary with me, like this huge dictionary, and then look up new words with them. With my parents, I'm just like, have you ever heard this word? So I love the power of words, and he has this gift for words. Like, he just puts things together, paints a picture and everything. So those are like my inspirations.
That's powerful. That's awesome. That's a solid list.
Yeah.
That's a solid list, man. Like, I'm kind of afraid for like kids in 20 years, and I'm gonna be like, oh, my idols are, I don't want to put any people. Lil Uzi and Lil Yachty, you know, he was, you know, and like, it's like, I just wonder, like, when we're going to get to the point where they will be like, who's Ice Cube? Who's Jay-Z? You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm like, whoa, guys. Like, I've already experienced what it means to date myself when, like, I make references to movies or music and kids or teenagers are like, I don't know what that is.
Yeah. No, it's our job though. We gotta keep
the right. We gotta keep it alive, right? Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? We gotta keep it going. Like, make sure they never forget. You know what I mean? Can't forget the legend. Can't forget the legend.
They paved so much for us.
Exactly.
They started so much.
Exactly. And I think about, you know, Sonya, you brought up Lauryn Hill. I thought she was definitely ahead of her time. You know, and, I mean, I think she definitely did more in one album than most artists. I'm not even just gonna say female artists.
Yeah.
Most artists during her career.
Yeah.
You know, and of course she's had her ups and downs like anybody, but. You know, I definitely think she had a message, you know, and I just remember her. I mean, she made it cool to talk about not just casually having sex. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like now we have songs that talk about how cool it is to have casual sex. You know what I mean? It's like so backwards.
It is. It's flipping the script on
me. Right, flipping the script. Like, hey, you know, we need less Lauryn Hill. You know, I'm like, no, we need more Lauryn Hill, more Lauryn Hill. Right. You know, it's funny because that makes me think about just like how important it is to just kind of have standards for yourself. And you know, everybody has different standards, but you know, I just wonder sometimes, particularly because I'm not an artist, you know, how do you reconcile, you know, having your own personal convictions and your personal standards with having opportunities to gain further exposure or to be on a platform that you know would, you know, give your music a longer reach. You know what I mean? Like, how do you, like, do you think about, you know, those opportunities presenting themselves and like, you know, what you'll do if someone says, hey, we'll give you X, Y, and Z, but you have to take off A, B, and C, or, you know, or you have to sing about this or that. You know what I mean? Like, do you ever think about those moments?
All the time.
You know?
My answer to that is honestly, God is good. Like, I'm a female artist with talent and gift, and I made a decision, I think even less than a year ago, that Chance the Rapper is another one of my, like, I love him. I look to him as an artist, as a rapper, as a lyricist, as an entrepreneur, as an independent artist.
Yeah.
And I know that when I got into getting further into the industry, I knew I didn't want to sell myself. Like, there was going to be no, like, sexuality. Like, I look at some of the young artists who can sing, and their videos, they're half naked, and they're doing these crazy things, and I'm thinking, like, do these girls even want, like, was that their vision for them?
Were they started?
Were they told? And I knew that what I wanted to do was bigger than that. I can say no, and I can fight off that pressure that the industry can push on me if I stay true to why I'm singing. I'm not singing, you know, just so people can hear. Ideally, God has given me a gift, and given me a talent to use it. So whatever I can do with that is what I'm going to focus on. I thought about that. Like, the chance I'm going to artists.
Yeah.
Like, maybe, you know, I can go the independent route. That can prevent from a lot of those industry pressures that can come from me from signing and things like that. But I know what I want. I know what I believe in. It's just about standing ground and surrounding myself with people that also support and surround and believe in the same things that I do. So,
I love it. I love what you said, standing your ground. You know, and I think that it's very easy to say no once, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But when you start feeling more pressure, you know, like, you said no the first time, but someone was like, okay, yeah, but what about this? You know, and like, because all it takes is a little bit of confidence,
Yeah, and you said something earlier where, I think Dave Chappelle, he was offered a certain amount of money, said no, in the future he got even more. And I think that's the kind of faith that I want to walk with, because I can say no to a good opportunity now, trust in God that it's not the right thing, and in the future he can reward me and give me even better than I couldn't even have fathomed at that point. It's just about being strong and believing. And I'm human, so like, money in my face, yeah, like, I'm hungry today, I'm too busy, that's the kind of thing.
Keep it real, Briella. Just keep pushing,
like, just keep believing, and then
we're all going to find space. Right, that's awesome. All right, cool. Let's give it, for the fans who want to know, like, you know, a little bit more about your creative process, you know, because I feel like, I mean, in anything, you know, when I start my day, I need my me time,
yeah.
You know? I need to be in the zone, I need certain music playing. Mm-hmm. I like the smell a certain way, you know? I just want the room to be in a certain aura,
yeah,
right? So when it comes to creating music, creating art for you, like, what do you feel like is your ideal environment for you to create? Like, when you like to write, or when you're in that creative space, or when you want to get in the studio, like, what do you like to have around you? What do you don't want around you at all? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Is there certain, like, types of music you want to listen to? Certain, like, do you watch anything? Do you read a certain book? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, what is that for you?
Yeah, I think I need a certain, as far as spiritually, I need a certain level of vulnerability before I can start writing. I have to feel some type of way before I can start writing. As far as, like, objects.
Some type of way?
Yeah. As far as objects, I really just need my guitar, my pen, and my paper. There's a couple times where I'll be sleeping and a lyric or a verse will come to me and I have to wake up, write it down before I forget it, and then it just starts a whole process. You know, I have projects where somebody asked me to write a poem.
Mm-hmm.
I went 2 weeks without thinking of anything. I'm sleeping, the lyric comes to me, I write the whole poem that sitting. So it doesn't, I don't necessarily need to create a space sometimes. It just happens for me. I do notice that I like to write my music kind of like somber lighting.
Yeah.
It's really like low lighting, candlelight, like little tea lights, what are they called? Like Christmas lights strung up
Christmas
in my room,
lights,
like
yeah.
Small lights like that. I don't like when it's like super bright.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's it. Like, I don't really need too much of a mood, just the right inspiration.
I feel you. Yeah. That's cool. And that's all it takes, man. That's all it takes. Just getting the mood right and the vibe right. Mm-hmm. Your environment is really important. That's awesome. Okay. So you've been really great catching these questions I've been throwing at you really quick. We're gonna switch it up a little bit.
Okay.
All right? You know, cause we're gonna bring this in for a landing in honor of the planes flying overhead, you know? I got a little segment, we call it this or that. Real quick, all right? You got 5 seconds, all right? I don't need you pondering too long, all right? It's all right, but you gotta be quick, you know what I'm saying? So it's all right, no pressure. I'm not about to throw anything too controversial at you. I don't know, at least I don't. But, all right, so real simple, okay? And you can say, and I'll give you, you get 1 meter.
Okay.
1 meter, and you can either choose to use it or keep it in your pocket. You use it too soon, you know what I'm saying? All right, so check this out, you ready? All right, Instagram or Facebook?
Instagram.
LeBron or Kobe?
LeBron.
T'Challa or Killmonger?
I don't know.
Sorry, we'll forgive
T'Challa
you.
T'Challa sounds like an African brother, so I went with
Black Panther. Forgive her, guys. Forgive her. Don't worry.
I watched the movie.
I will literally pay for her ticket to go see.
No. You said
Killmonger.
You said T'Challa and it rang a bell, but Killmonger lost me. I thought it was a Pokemon. I was like, wait. I was like, I don't know Pokemon.
Hey, for the record, there are probably some kids watching who don't know what Pokemon are, so it's all right, guys. You're too young. Google it. Google it. Or YouTube.
Interweb.
Whatever. It's alright. Alright, we'll give you that. Alright. Beards or no beards?
Beards all the way.
Oh, Lord.
Do your beard hang low. All the way.
Shout out to my men who don't have beards.
No, yeah. Do your thing. Hang your face.
Alright. Alright. I don't know. Alright. For music. Musically. This one is musically. Beyonce. Pancakes or waffles?
Waffles.
All right. Eating or sleeping?
Eating. I don't like sleeping. I like eating. I'll eat rather.
All right, that's fair. Okay, and one more. Frosted Flakes or Fruity Pebbles?
Frosted Flakes.
Give me one top. I heard somebody say Fruity Pebbles. I thought they were crazy. I know, right? That was wild. Well, awesome. Thank you so much for joining us, Briella. Thanks, guys, for tuning in. I hope you guys feel like you got a better look at what she's doing. Just catch her set. Hopefully, we'll be able to get some footage up for you. You know, I know you're going to do your thing. I'm excited to see it. You know, and good luck to you in the future.
Thank you.
I'm sure you got big things coming for you.
Yeah,
all right, guys. We'll see you again soon.
Everything you do in time. You know it takes time.
Just goes back to you. Yeah.
just goes back to you. Show!